Well, today is Retro Jesus Song, and thank you for joining us, by the way. Comes back about a generation ago, 30 years ago. The late, great Carman. Are you ready for your test today, by the way? That test is going to be shown to you as Carman begins to be a teacher, teaching about the Middle Ages. Here we go.
Adam, you know today is the day for the big test.
Great God is the name of the song.
Why don't you give us the benefit of your knowledge?
Sure applies today.
Tell us about the Dark Ages. You know, the place where you've been for the past 10 years. As the Grand Inquisitor would say, pray ye lessee, recite for us your book.
Sorry.
What I thought. As you all know, today is the day for the big test. You're okay, Joe. Before I hand these out, I just want to summarize what this test is going to be on. We've been studying about the 1500s and the time of the Inquisition and why they called it the Dark Ages. Yeah.
I know all the facts and figures, but I don't get it. Why did the 16th century church want to kill people that wanted to be Christians?
Well, the church didn't do it. You see, the church is the body of Christ, and the body of Christ is not going to kill itself. It was the evil spiritual forces behind those in leadership positions. You see, when the Word of God is eliminated as the standard for life, people don't know right from wrong. Good becomes evil, evil becomes good, all because they have no standard to measure truth by. Just remember this, that the standard for right and wrong is the Word of God. And the Word of God is like a sword that fight off the forces of the enemy that's behind the problem. Now, if you have the Word of God in your hand, you can be a greater threat to the evil of your day than the evil of your day. Ready? Let's go.
Rise, lassie. Rise and shine. It's your big test today. Of the scripture to the commoners without the permission or the guidance of the archbishop. Father heretic, who do you think you are? Pray, recite to us, what is your doctrine?
God is a God of righteousness. God sits on the throne. God is strong in battle. God is God alone. God is wise and merciful. God is sovereign and glorious.
King, ruler of everything. He's a great God. We'll proclaim, honor and glory.
sentence you to death by beheading. Have any last words, sir, before you die?
Yes. Blessing and glory and wisdom, thanksgiving and honor and power and life be to our God forever and ever, and all the saints say,
holy.
Mid-1990s, that was Carman, the Great God song, and I tell you, take up the sword of the Spirit, for the word of God is more powerful than any two-edged sword, and no matter where you go, don't leave home without it, the word of God in your heart, in your head, in your soul. Powerful words, powerful demonstration. May the Lord be with you. It applies today as it did yesterday.